Now I want to introduce Johanna Wright. She's the lead product manager of search for many years, launching such innovations as universal search, instant, and the knowledge graph. And now she's leading up search in Android, including Google Now, voice search, and speech.
Let's step back to January 2003. At this point in time, I'm living in my father-in-law's house. He's put a nice curtain up for my section of the living room where my husband and I share an air mattress. The sun streams in, 6 a.m. we wake up every morning because of the unbearable Orange County heat. The air mattress is popped and I'm unemployed. Just 6 months earlier, I was a young tech exec in New York. First during the dot-com boom and then bust. But my company that I worked at had finally shut its doors, and my husband and I decided to get on our bicycles and ride across the country to lovely, sunny LA. Riding across the country with your new husband is a lot of fun. Showing up in LA, a new city with no job, not so much fun. Then the rejection letters from business school started pouring in. And it's January, and there's only one business school I haven't heard back from, but I'm not feeling too optimistic because they're supposed to interview all of their candidates, and they're going to mail out their verdict 2 days later, and they still haven't interviewed me. But then I got an email from UCLA that said, "We want to interview you." And since my confidence had been shot, my response was, "You do?" I was fortunate enough to get to go to UCLA for business school, and then I got a job at Google. And today I'm going to talk about my career starting out at Google and what it was like to be a product manager at Google and give some bits of advice about product management. But my first piece of career advice is that your career is not going to be linear. Expect to be disrupted. This is a disruptive industry, and you too may someday be unemployed on your father-in-law's couch. What's really going to matter is the energy and the tenacity with which you pick yourself up and take on your next adventure. Okay, so let's jump into Google. I was hired to be a product manager working in search. My boss gave me two options of jobs. One was something called universal search. Universal search was a project where we took all the content from our different backends, maps, videos, images, and we put them in the main search results pane. The other option that she gave me was to do something called premium content search. This is where we searched all the content behind paywalls and put it in the search results. Both of these things seemed pretty interesting, and I was so new to Google, I didn't have any context or judgment to make a decision. Fortunately for me, I'd gone to the same business school as Susan Wojcicki, my fellow panelist, and so I asked her for some advice. Susan looked at me like I had two heads. "What? Of course you should do universal search. That's our business, Johanna." So this leads to another piece of career wisdom. What does a good opportunity look like? Well, a good opportunity looks like something that's strategic. If you're doing something that's in line with the company's mission and has not been done before, well, then it's very likely to be a good opportunity. Okay, so let me jump into universal search. This was 2005 at Google. Google was growing like crazy. It was very chaotic. It's kind of hard to know, for me, it was hard to know how projects got assigned, what you were working on, and I got paired up with an infrastructure team while I was working on universal search. This was a great team, but a team that was very focused on building infrastructure, and they didn't want to build any features. And I was a product manager, and I was being judged on the features that I launched, and so it was pretty stressful because I wasn't delivering anything. And so what I ended up doing was creating a set of mocks, a series of mocks of what universal search could look like. And then I created a little PowerPoint deck, and I walked around Google, and I introduced myself to anyone who looked like they might want to be a features tech lead to see if they wanted to join my project. And I was fortunate enough to meet a person named David Bailey who wanted to join on and lead the features side of the effort. And then the project really started to get legs. And so here's my beginning of my product management specific advice, and that is to paint a vision. Once you paint a vision and you share your vision, people will follow. It'll be a lot easier to follow once you have a vision. Okay, so David and I started. There was a big mountain in front of us. We didn't really know what to do. This project had failed a number of times before. We didn't really know why it had failed. And I had this idea that we should do a user study. I was trying to figure out what to do. I said, let's just do a user study. So we pulled together a prototype to do our user study. And once we had this prototype, the people around us in Google started to be able to imagine that this product might come to life and that something might happen. And so this brings me to my second piece of product management advice, which is that if you don't really know what to do, you should just do something. Do something to move the ball forward. I was very fortunate, though, that a user study was what we decided to do because people loved it. And it was so awesome, we learned that the project and the product had legs. So I remember sitting in the labs, and it was in the spring of 2006 for our user study, and one of the searches we asked people to do was Barry Bonds. Now, this was a long time ago. This was the dark ages. YouTube was just starting out. But there was a home video that someone had uploaded of Barry Bonds tying Babe Ruth's home run record. And the participant in our study, she clicked on the video. She watched the ball sail out into the field, and she had this big smile on her face. It wasn't unnatural at all that she saw this video in the search results. So we knew the project had legs, and it was just a great moment. So my final and most important piece of product management advice is to listen to your users, and even more importantly, use your products yourself. Just this weekend when I was using Android Search, I noticed that speech recognition is slow, like maybe 1 in 7 times. I don't know why, but I'm really glad that we're investing in speed. Then I also had some magical experiences with Google Now. So I was invited to go to a birthday party in Burlingame, and Google Now reminded me about the party. And it even told me that Burlingame was 30 minutes from my house, which I didn't know, and it was super helpful. The more you use your products, the easier it is to make decisions and to have an intuitive feel for what you should be doing. So I'll summarize my product management advice. 1, paint a vision. 2, when you don't know what to do, just make mini milestones. Roll that ball forward. And 3, use your products. Since this is a Women's Tech Makers event, I thought I'd close with my very own lean-in story. So back when all this universal search stuff was going on, I ended up getting pregnant. And when I was 8 months pregnant, my boss, Marissa Meyer, suggested that I lead a team of senior engineers to come up with a search strategy for the next year. Now, the search strategy, the process, the normal process was to set this meeting in mid-November, but my baby was supposed to be born at the end of October. And so they were like, hey, no problem, we'll just move the date up. Didn't give me very much time to prepare. And my baby was something that you call transverse, so he's lying on his side, and I had to have a C-section. So they moved the date up. I moved my C-section to the very last possible date. We met in the middle. And on Wednesday, I gave the strategy presentation. On Thursday, I had my baby. Now, this might be horrifying to some of you, but to me, it was invigorating. And it set me up to have a leadership role in search when I return from my leave. And the point I want you to take away is not that you need to sacrifice your family for your career. I feel fortunate enough that I haven't had to do that. You see, there was no question in my mind that given that opportunity, I would want to give that presentation. And it was really huge that my manager believed in me. So the takeaway that I'd like us to take is that as managers, we shouldn't assume people's abilities or desires. We should ask. As managers, it's our job to enable greatness in our teams.